Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Real Talk. My name is Nicole Asinogo and I'm at Vesta Coffee in Victoria Island, here to meet some really cool people for some Real Talk. Let's go.
Today on Real Talk, we have media personality Denola Gray, TV host and producer Sheyiton Atigarin. We have on-air personality OC Suave.
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah,
hi. How are you guys?
I'm good.
Nice to see you
so
all.
Good.
Thank you. Should we jump right into it?
Yeah.
Why not? Right? So I think it's safe to say that social media has taken over our lives. Mm-hmm. So I have a question to ask you. Mm-hmm. Ben, how many times a day do you check social media?
Oh my God. Jeez. I mean, if you asked me this question about maybe a month ago, I'm always on my phone. Mm-hmm. And it's not even just, I mean, social media, WhatsApp, everything is on your phone.
Yeah.
So like, you're just always tempted to go back to Instagram to check something or just quickly go to Snapchat to see.
Honestly, at some point, it was the first thing I was checking when I woke up. And then I kind of stopped doing that because I felt bad about life. But yeah, it's really bad.
Yeah.
All day, every day.
Yeah.
Well, I tweet a lot, so yeah, I'm always on Twitter.
Oh yeah, we know.
we know.
See, so I'm always on Twitter. Snapchat and Instagram, not too much. But yeah, Twitter, yeah.
Okay,
so then my messaging apps as well. So
you tweet a lot. So do you spend more time like just airing your opinion or do you spend time like reading other people's tweets?
Well, I rarely read other people's tweets. So
our opinions don't count.
I didn't mean that though. But I just find it very, like, it's like a mini diary. Mm-hmm. So stuff pop in your head and, you know, I like the fact that you can interact and stuff.
Mm-hmm. The number of times I see your name pop up on my timeline.
It's weird, I mean.
And it's like always followed by like an angry tweet.
always.
Know how to just like,
yeah.
Get.
I'm just like.
Yeah.
I think I'm largely misunderstood. Mm-hmm. Yeah, by a lot of people.
Why are you guys laughing now? He's
because that's what people say.
when they're like,
you know.
And I feel I say stuff that guys don't want to say.
Okay.
Because guys are like, oh, I don't want to offend ladies or I don't want to come off a certain type of way.
Okay.
And I'm like,
but
we know this is what's up though.
Okay.
Yeah. Then, okay, I read a lot and I'm knowledgeable about a lot of stuff, politics. Mm. So if I'm tweeting about certain subject areas and everything, people are like, oh, I act like I know everything. And I'm like, I don't know everything, but I just consume a lot of information.
So you said people on social media?
Yeah.
But do you find yourself like looking at other people's lives on social media?
Yeah. We're having a really horrible day and you like go on social media and somebody's like living the life that you want, like it just infuriates you more.
Mm-hmm.
Do
you feel that it feeds like that comparison spirit?
Yeah, but then, you know, like again, you know, with time, you now realize that it's like all smoke and mirrors and like literally it's not real. But at the same time, like you just feel like, oh my gosh, everybody's like living their best life and I'm just like here, not doing anything. My life sucks. This is terrible.
Yeah.
You know, like there's all this pressure that we put on ourselves based on that access to other people's lives.
You spoke about smoke and mirrors. So would you say like social media is this kind of facade? Like people that live like a very lavish life on social media.
Mm-hmm.
Like you have people, the jet setting people from Dubai to Cannes.
The thing about the jet setting life and all that is like some people genuinely are living those lives and like that's their reality and their truth.
But what about people that are putting up this facade? Like we had that Bow Wow challenge.
That was hilarious. That was so funny.
Yes.
And I think what was funnier than the picture was his explanation behind it because it didn't make any sense.
But the truth of the matter is that, you know, taking a private jet in America, it's not even that expensive.
It's $20,000.
Yeah, $15,000, $20,000.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you have $20,000?
Me?
Yeah.
Yes, I do.
Like to grab it.
No, I won't. Yeah. I was not afraid. No, but yeah.
Why do you think Bow Wow did that?
Well, because how would I put it right now? A whole lot of people judge, a whole brands, people, your followers, everybody judge you based on, you know, what's going on your social media.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Sometimes if brands want to use you for stuff, they'll be like, okay, how many followers does he have?
Yeah.
Or what is he about? Mm-hmm. So there's a need to want to feel among or want to project.
Live up to that expectation.
Yeah. So it's like, it has created like a false reality for a whole lot of people.
Mm.
So
do you
people
feel that
buy,
pressure?
Nah, I'm 30.
Okay.
Yeah, but, you know, so.
That's not that.
Yeah, I am. So I don't give a rat's ass
anymore. Okay.
Maybe I used to when I was younger, but right now it's like I don't have anything to prove to anybody.
Mm-hmm.
You
yeah.
understand? So I can't be, what's the word right now? I wouldn't be that guy that, okay, I'd save all my money instead of maybe trying to buy a property and buying a Rolex to show. And I'm
that's
so, you know, so, you know, I just try as much because I know where I'm coming from. Mm-hmm. You get? So I just, you know, leave me to whatever makes me happy.
But then these people that post these lavish things and live these lavish lives. Mm-hmm. They have a lot of followers.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
You know, is that what people want to see?
It's aspirational. People want to aspire to things.
I mean, like, especially on Instagram, for example, people feel like, you know, the more followers you have a kind of, that's kind of like your worth. Like it's, when, no, it, it's true. You think about it because look, they say, oh, Kim Kardashian has
100 million followers.
It's really about striking the right balance. Like, for example, I wouldn't, one thing I can never do, I would never go and buy followers. You see, they have 100,000 followers and then their pictures, they have like 10 likes. 10, it doesn't make any sense. For me, see, there are people that I follow that I'm just, I just go there, I'm like, oh my, when I see the private, I'm like, you know what, very soon, coming through. Mm-hmm. Like, it inspires me, it doesn't really make me jealous. I mean, like, why am I jealous?
So imagine if you meet somebody, right, and the person on paper is everything you've been looking for, you guys connect, your soulmates, you know this is the person that God made for you.
And she's a troll on social media.
No, you guys get together, you're in a relationship, you're about to go into a relationship, and the person asks you to delete your social media, that they're just not comfortable with social media.
Is this person on social media as well?
No. Maybe this... Facebook. But the person asks you to delete your Twitter. So I'll put it to you, because...
I'm missing my face.
So the girl says to you,
Bye.
She says, baby,
yeah,
I love you.
Oh, okay. But you can delete your Twitter.
But I need you to delete your Twitter because I feel like your attention is divided.
Bye.
No. So you would break up with her?
And the problem is that if you can't respect the fact that I should keep my individuality in this relationship, that means you're not good for me.
She met you with social media.
Yeah, so hey.
But maybe she feels like social media is more of a cancer as opposed to a catalyst.
No, I make money off Twitter. So you can't, you can't play my money though.
And then I'll tell her, that sounds like a personal problem.
Yeah, so fix it.
You know?
Okay.
Sort yourself
that's
out.
That's just the reason why we can't date. That's why we're dating to find, you know, to be able to sort out to see if I can spend the rest of my life.
What about a compromise? What if the person is just not comfortable with
reduce the amount of tweets you put out? So I can do that.
No, yeah. Why? Just be like, listen, here's the situation, okay? I do my thing, you do your thing.
But do you love this person?
Yeah, but like it has no bearing on way. Like, I'm not tweeting about you. It's not affecting you in any way.
But the person is telling you that all these tweets that you're putting out, or all your Instagrams, your constant attention, looking for the likes, waiting for the likes to come in, talking to people that are not
that's an excess.
Like, it's always good to like. There's something that you bring to me that's.
Yeah.
Maybe for example, now, you know how you give that example? Where in April you felt like, okay, you know what?
Fine. I'll take that. To
me, then we can talk about it. But you can't just walk up to me and tell me,
delete your social media.
Yeah. Hello, do you know how long it took me to get these followers?
And I know my followers are important.
I mean, like, you know, social media is a tool. Isn't that why it was created in the first place?
It's become part of our society right now.
Exactly. Like, most of the jobs I get, or most of, you know, people I've worked with, most of them actually go to my social media first. Yeah. Before they approach you, it's like a virtual CV.
If people have like a business profile, they can even contact you through your email.
Yeah,
from
Instagram.
Just
a click.
Yeah.
I've gotten loads and loads of emails because my email address is attached to my Twitter bio or anything. So yeah.
Do you feel a pressure on social media to be funny, to be witty, or are you just yourself?
The problem right now is that, okay, technically I've dated a lot of people and normally
technically,
okay.
So females are always naturally attracted to guys that are funny and intelligent and witty. Mm-hmm. So the way you tweet or the way your mind works reflects in how your tweets come out or how your Instagram posts or whatever. Okay. So there are a whole lot, we've seen cases of people stealing, you know, jokes and posting stuff and because of the, oh my God, you're so funny comments and everything and all. So at the end of the day though, I think social media has a lot of good sides but the really bad parts and everything is that it's just made everything, you know, just more difficult and weird. Mm-hmm.
Do you feel like social media perpetrates, you know, there's some particular kind of relationships that look better, couple goals,
I'm not going to lie, that thing has affected me. Like,
there are some couple goals.
Some of those things are actually real, like some of them are not, but like at the same time, it's all aspirational.
But it's aspirational, but you're only seeing the good side. They're not
going to
feel
anything like
it. There's nothing wrong with wishing for the good stuff. I mean, if you see a couple in real life and you see them, you know, doing couple goal things, you'd admire them. But now,
like
social media, it's just...
But like I suppose you even said earlier, like,
is
you
that
know,
your couple goals?
No, maybe 20 years ago.
Okay.
Yeah. But I'm just saying, like, now, it's just because it's because
you can see.
But wish, do you think like, it puts an unrealistic...
No, I think it puts pressure on people's relationships.
Yeah, it does.
I'm not... like guys. Even dating Chato, for example, I'm a kind of guy.
It's coming from
babe. Yeah, I don't want her. I don't want to get on Twitter and she's tweeting at me. Mm-hmm. Oh, babe, remember to bring. And I'm like, you have my, you know. Mm-hmm. And there are people that do this constantly. Mm-hmm. So when they have fights, everybody knows.
Yes. Yeah.
When they have broken up, everybody knows. Then, you
and
understand?
Then, and they're putting on the passive aggressive.
You like, understand?
Emotional. Mm-hmm. Means,
yeah. Like on so but I'm saying that you can be in a relationship with somebody that you know is on Twitter or anything, and you know the occasional pictures, the occasional, oh hey babe, I just want to let you know I love you, you know. But it's not like in your, because when you now make it in your face, everybody now starts to work like, okay, let's see where this is
and
going
they also
to.
Kind of feel like they have a right to your relationship.
Yeah,
yes. once
I mean,
even with another person, even with another third party, it's already hard enough. But if you have like the whole world.
We decided to take Real Talk to the streets.
It's not everything we read in social media we use for our, it's real life. Some couples will be killing themselves inside. But outside, they're like, I love you, Romeo and Juliet. We're all different, you understand? We don't compare ourselves with others.
Social media reduces people's self-esteem. You see somebody dressing nice and you don't have, and is your friend, you have this low self-esteem. You don't feel among.
I don't subscribe to putting your every move you make on your relationship. Maybe you go out on a date and it's on Facebook, it's on Instagram, like me and my bae on a date. I wouldn't do that because from examples of celebrities that we see, they do all that, then before you know, it's crashed.
We put so much online. You put your breakfast online, your coffee, your lunch. Well, so no, why can't really you put your relationship?
There's nobody can tell me, oh, don't eat that bread. I'm just saying, it's my bread.
Yeah,
I just
yeah,
ate
it's
it.
My relationship.
No, but yeah, but it's my relationship. Yeah.
But the thing is, for something that's so dynamic, because human beings are dynamic, I don't. Social media is like whatever you put out there is out there. Mm-hmm. There's some permanence to it.
You
so
can't
like,
take it back.
For something that's so dynamic, you really shouldn't be like putting something out there that's so. On a permanent platform.
Is there any instance that any of you have put out something that you wish you could have taken back?
Yeah, I did. Definitely. I took a picture she was naked or something.
Okay.
Yeah, it was in front of us. Yeah. So I put it up and yeah, I think it got on Linda EKG. I mean, goodness, man.
What was going through your mind when
nothing,
you did that?
It was a nice picture.
Did she want you to post it?
Our face wasn't showing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did you ask her though?
Yeah, I did. Okay. No, but when you, and you know, like, Nigeria is an uber conservative society. So, oh my God, called the girl. No, she's who married this one. I'm like, but you don't know her face. It's not like you're going to, oh, let me see your butt or anything.
Speaking of naked girls, what do you guys think of like people that, you know, wear basically nothing to get followers and all that kind of stuff?
I mean, they may not be doing it to get followers. They may just doing it because they want to just show their body to the world.
I don't know.
Girls do this thing every time. You take pictures, they're like, there's the side so the hips can show, there's the butt. I'm like,
but like,
and
the
you
poses
don't like
have.
Her, you don't
no,
like
I think it's tacky as hell.
The poses have actually gotten out of hand.
No, like the whole, okay, there's a picture. We obviously know that you have a fat ass or something.
Okay.
So you just take a full back shot.
She's like sitting on the sink.
Yeah.
You know, she's
like, it. Those kind of girls have lots of followers.
And they get, and they, those pictures get the most likes. So.
Yeah, they get the most likes.
I mean, it might not be for your kind of guy. You know,
okay,
can we just agree that like the pose is actually getting out of hand? Like girls are not posing like Spider-Man right now. There's one that they do
like
where they are like on the floor and they put one leg out, then they're backing it up like that. And I blame Kylie Jenner.
Well, it's just like you're just doing stuff for likes from strange. I don't.
It doesn't make sense.
I'm not gonna lie to you.
I'm like, I don't know, man. Really.
There was a time. There was actually sometime in February. I felt like I was living my life in numbers. Like, I become so into the whole social media thing, and I was like constantly refreshing like my thing to make sure that nobody was saying anything horrible under my pictures, or if this picture got a certain amount of likes, then that means it was bomb. And then the minute I said anything like that, I deleted my Instagram app for a whole week. I just like went off Instagram.
For a week?
For a week. For me, which is
a lot.
It's a lot for me. I didn't post anything on Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter. I just like went whole turkey for a whole week. And honestly, it was the most freeing thing ever. It was affecting my self-esteem. Like I was like, oh, this picture is not, it's not doing too well, so maybe I'm not looking my best. And I was like, that's so dumb. Like before I just put things,
I'm not caring.
So I finally got back to that. I don't care anymore.
You know they say social media, like it releases dopamine.
Some dopamine,
and it makes you feel good. So when you get the likes, it makes you feel good. Yeah.
I mean, for me, I can totally relate what you just said. Because like a month ago, it actually went off. And it wasn't even just Instagram. It was Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter. But I just didn't renew my data subscription. And I,
you know, every time I kind of found myself, you know, reaching for my phone, and then I could even hear
yes, yes.
Wow. It just made me realize how like that everything is just on this phone, and it's crazy.
You know what I hate?
Hi guys.
Girls that put up a picture, like a sexy picture, and then put like, God is so
glory
good.
Glory be to God. See, I glory said it again.
God. God. Your
I hate those
I mean, but you're like, still saved.
The only way you can make it to heaven is through Jesus.
And then they said,
I'm like, I can see your areola. What's wrong with you?
I don't like that either.
Okay. Really? Do you guys have any last words on social media?
Live your life. But again, apart from those,
it's not that deep. I mean, for me, it's a tool. For other people, it's a way of life.
I would say you're right. It's not that deep. People just need to unclench and you know.
Why are they clenching?
You just don't have a stick
what
up your butt.
You?
Sane.
Oh, okay.
But generally, I would say that, you know, with anything, excess is bad. So like, if it's like ruining your life, then you have to take a step back and just kind of like really look at what's really important. Yeah. Hey,
thank you guys so much for joining us. I really enjoyed it.
Anytime.
If you guys enjoyed this episode, please join the conversation in the comments. Follow us on social media @NdaniTV and make sure you subscribe to our channel. Bye.